Hi everyone, welcome to my new video series Python Learning for Network Engineers. Before we start, I would like to speak about my experience in Python. I'm working in network industry for more than 10 years now, so my core expertise is in designing, implementing and troubleshooting network infrastructures. So I have learned Python in a network context. So these videos are going to be more based on network device configurations. I believe these videos are going to help network engineers who doesn't have any coding experience and who would like to write some codes to automate their day-to-day task. Now I'll talk about some of the advantages of Python. So it is simple to learn language. I would say it is a very readable language. Even if you don't have any coding experience, you will be able to read and learn it easily. Another advantage with Python is it supports a wide range of operating systems. For example, it supports most of the Linux distributions. It supports on Windows OS, Mac OS, etc. And even you might have noticed, even some of the network vendors started supporting Python built-in in their operating system itself. And most of the networking devices, and the vendors started focusing on device APIs and scripting. By considering all this, I believe ability to understand programming or scripting will allow us to align with the current trends in the industry. So this is the right time for network engineers to learn some programming, at least from a network context. This video is just an introduction for this Python series. From the next video onwards, we'll start some real-time demos on Python. In the upcoming videos, I'll be showing how to install Python, how to manage multiple versions of Python, then how to install package manager like pip, then how to follow Python community's recommendation on coding, then how to install external libraries in Python, and how to use built-in and external libraries in coding, how to use the modules in Python. Everything I'll be demonstrating in this video series. Throughout this series, I'll be referring python.org site for the recommendations and best practices. So I'll be going to the documentation, then Python index documents, etc. So we'll be going through this site a lot. So that's all about introduction. I hope this video series is going to help you to understand core basics and write your own code in Python. See you in the next video, where I'll be starting real-time configurations and demos of Python. So especially in next video, I'll be showing how to install Python in multiple methods. Thank you. See you in the next video.